Hello everyone, I am Dr. Pranjali Bisht and today we are here to perform our next practical again in volumetric analysis. We will going to determine the strength of unknown ferrous ammonium sulfate by using internal indicator diphenylamine. So in this practical we will going to calculate the strength of ferrous ammonium sulfate solution by titrating it against the known potassium dichromate solution. So here potassium dichromate solution is an oxidizing agent and it is not acidified. We will going to add acid in the reaction mixture. So in presence of acid, this potassium dichromate will going to oxidize the ferrous ions of the ferrous ammonium sulfate into the ferric ions. Simultaneously the chromium will get reduced. So here oxidation and reduction both are taking place. So such type of titrations are known as redox titration. So let us start the determination of ferrous ammonium sulfate using internal indicator diphenylamine. So for this we will going to fill the burette with the help of funnel and we will going to add potassium dichromate solution. Since it is the colored solution, so we will going to check the upper meniscus. So we have filled the burette and the knob is closed. We have the capacity of 50 ml. So 50 ml of potassium dichromate is added to this. So firstly we will going to standardize this potassium dichromate with the help of known ferrous ammonium sulfate. So I am going to take this ferrous ammonium sulfate. We are going to pipette out this ferrous ammonium sulfate with the help of pipette. We need to pipette out 25 ml of ferrous ammonium sulfate. So till the mark, we need to suck the ferrous ammonium sulfate. Since we need to use the internal indicator, so I will going to add internal indicator to it. But before it, I will going to add the 50 ml of normal tap water to avoid the premature reading. In this practical, we get reading very early. So to avoid the premature reading, we will going to dilute this solution. Now to this solution, I will going to add the acid, H2SO4. So 5 ml of the acid is added to this solution. So this is 5 ml of the H2SO4 to make it acidified. Now I will going to add 2 to 3 drops of diphenylamine. Okay, so this is our reaction mixture or analyte. Now I will going to titrate it with the potassium dichromate. So in this practical, this is known and this is unknown. So this is done to standardize the dichromate. So I will going to loose this knob. As you can see, the color is changing. This was the colorless solution. Now we will get the purple color. This is due to the kunite formation of the diphenylamine. Diphenylamine has two phenyl group and during the reaction the phenyl groups will get converted into kunoite form and the color of this kunoite form is purple. You can see the appearance of the purple color with each drop. Is it visible? I will going to shake this solution. Until all the iron get oxidized, the chromate will be consumed.
17 ml is consumed. Yes, I will get the purple color soon. Yes, as you can see, so this is the end point of this titration. We have got the dark bluish purple or purplish color. So I will going to close this knob. So this is purple, light purple color solution. So the color indicates the formation of cunoid and the completion of the reaction. So this is how we will going to end the titration. This is the end point, and at this end point we need to note down the reading. So it is here 19 ml in the burine. So by using this reading, we will going to calculate the strength of potassium dichromate. So for next practical, this will be our standard solution, and instead of known ferrous ammonium sulfate, we will going to take the unknown ferrous ammonium sulfate, and we will going to repeat the titration again through with internal indicator, that is diphenhydramine. Thank you.